Okay, so let's see how I can design my pipeline to perhaps take the TLB off the critical path. Okay, let me clear out this slide again. So, you know, here's my core, it's issuing a load, it's producing a virtual address. Okay, and now, you know, here's my data array for the L1 cache. Here's my tag array for the L1 cache. And now, instead of looking up the TLB first, I'm going to look at the TLB in parallel. Okay, so the virtual address is being fed over here. It's being used to index into the caches. The virtual address is also being used to look up the TLB. Okay, so one cycle later, you know, so I'm producing virtual address, let's say ABC. There's a translation over here saying that ABC maps to PQR. So, you know, one cycle later, I produce the translation saying the physical address for this virtual address ABC is PQR. Okay, and also said that, you know, what I should be saving in the tags are the physical addresses. So I should be saving PQR over here, right? So after some time, the tag should produce a result saying what I have saved over here is PQR. Now I can do the comparison and I can say this is a cache hit, right? And so accordingly, whatever data is read out ends up being sent back to the CPU. Okay, so all of this, you know, seems to be exactly like before. I just did the TLB access in parallel and things seem to be working just as before. There is one big difference though. Before, I was using the physical address to index into the cache. And now I'm using the virtual address to index into the cache. Okay, so if ABC indexes over here, and if ABB indexes over here, I will never have a cache hit, right? Because there could be another tag over here that says, you know, PQR, right? So when thread one brings in the data, it brings in the data over here and keeps the tag over here. When the second thread looks up, looks for ABB, it perhaps maps to a different set and it brings its own cache copy and places it over here. So again, you have this problem where there are duplicate copies of the same block in cache. Right? So again, this is not going to work. So the only way that this organization is going to work if ABC and ABB both map to the exact same set. If they map to different sets, then again, you'll have a problem where you create two cache copies for one physical address. Okay, so we have to somehow force both of these different virtual addresses to map to the same set. Okay, and thankfully this is not as hard as you might initially think. Okay, so let's look at the address. Okay, let's look at the virtual address being produced. Okay, we had said earlier that, you know, part of the virtual address is the page offset. So this is the page offset. Okay, and the rest of it is my virtual page number. And if I'm dealing with, say, 8 kilobyte pages, then, you know, there are 13 bits of page offset over here. Okay, and the rest of it is my virtual page number. Okay, now let's go back to the discussion we had, you know, a few weeks back or a few videos ago, where we said that if you look at the address, right, the address is broken up. I'm just making another copy of the same address. And I said that when I look up the cache, the last few bits are my block offset. So if I'm keeping 32 byte blocks, then, you know, there are 5 bits over here. Then the next few bits are my index into the cache. And the rest of it is called the tag. Okay, now if I have a small L1 cache with 256 sets, then I have 8 index bits over here. Okay, so what this means is that the index bits and the block offset could be part of my page offset, right? So these two essentially are both being mapped into my page offset. Okay, and when I translate my virtual address to the physical address, the page offset doesn't really undergo any translation, right? I mean, this is just saying that within a page, you know, how far away am I from the start of the page? And that's going to be the same in the virtual space and in the physical space. Okay, so when I convert a virtual address to a physical address, it is only the virtual page number that gets translated into a physical page number. These offset bits basically remain unchanged. Okay, and so what this now means is translating the offset bits to the physical offset bits is like a dummy translation. It's an identity translation where it's going to be exactly the same. Okay, so in some sense, I already have the last 13 bits of my physical address, right? So when I'm given a virtual address, I currently have its virtual page number and I have its offset bits. this has to be translated into a physical page number, but this is already translated into the physical space, right? It's going to be exactly the same. There's really no translation over here. So what it means is, you know, when I'm looking up the cache, I already know the last 13 bits of my physical page number. Okay, and those are the only bits I need to index into the cache, right? Because I'm going to index into the cache with these 8 bits. Okay, and those 8 bits of the physical address are already known because it's a dummy translation. Okay, so this means that with my virtual address, I can now look up my cache, and the indexing will be the same as before. And this means that, you know, ABC and ABB will both map to the same set. Okay, so, you know, if my L1 cache was somehow bigger and it had more sets, if it had 512 sets, I would need 9 index bits, which means I would need one more bit from here. Right, so now I'm spilling into the space that does undergo translation. Right, so this is the last bit of my virtual page number. When I convert into the physical space, this last bit may become a 0 or a 1 depending on which physical page is being used. Right, so now if I had used a really large L1 cache where I need bits which are passed part of the physical page number, now it becomes hard for me, and it's possible that ABC and ABB map to different sets, you know, based on how this last bit undergoes translation. Okay, so, you know, I have to very carefully design my L1 data cache to make sure that its index bits are completely being taken from the page offset bits. As soon as I need bits from the virtual page number, then I do have to go through the TLB to know, you know, what the physical bits are going to be. And, you know, those are the bits I will then have to use to index into the cache. Okay, so, you know, if you look at a cache that has 256 sets, you know, two ways, 32 byte blocks, it means that, you know, so this has a total capacity of, you know, 16 kilobytes. So 16 kilobytes, you know, two-way cache can work with this kind of mechanism. And this is called, you know, virtual indexing, because I'm using my virtual address to index into the cache. And this is also called physically tagged, because ultimately the tags are storing the physical addresses. They're storing PQR and not ABC and ABB. Okay, so for these designs to work, they have to be virtually indexed and physically tagged. You can also build a cache that is physically indexed and physically tagged, but then that requires you to do the TLB access first and then look at the data and tag arrays, and that has a longer access time. Okay, so I just showed you how virtual indexed physically tagged caches can work correctly and also have high performance because the TLB access is happening in parallel with the data and tag lookups, and there is no aliasing problem. There's no confusion about, you know, having multiple copies of the same physical address, because I'm ensuring that even with the virtual index, you know, two different virtual addresses will still map to the same set. You know, two different virtual names for the same physical page will still map to the same set. And this is because the index is being derived entirely from the page offset bits, which are really unchanged as you move from the virtual address space to the physical address space. Okay, so this is how, you know, most caches are designed today. And I'm going through another example in this slide over here, where I'm using a 24-bit virtual address space. I'm using a 4 kilobyte page size. I'm showing you addresses in the hexadecimal space. So, you know, each of this corresponds to 4 bits. Each alphabet over here corresponds to 4 bits. So this is my 24-bit address. Okay, and two different pages that are, you know, two different threads, and a single page in physical memory, which has two different names, ABCDEF and ABBDEF. Okay, so, you know, in this case, I have 12 bits of offset because it's 4 kilobyte page size. So the last 3 bits are my page offset, and you'll see that they're exactly the same. They're DEF in both cases. Okay, and so it's only the virtual page number, which is ABC and ABB, and, you know, both will be translated into the same physical page number. If I have a small cache, then my index is contained within DEF. Right, so both of these will map to the exact same set. If I have a really large cache and I need, say, 16 bits to index in, then, you know, this thread will index in with CDEF, right? And so CDEF maps to this set, and this thread will index with BDEF, which maps to a different set. And so, you know, there will be confusion, there will be two different cache copies, and you will never agree. Okay, so you have to make sure that this cache is small enough, or it has few enough sets that they can be indexed with bits that happen to be part of the offset bits for the page.